Did you know that the best performer in the EV industry in 2022 wasn't Tesla? Yep, you heard that right. In fact, the best performer last year was actually a Chinese EV manufacturer called Build Your Dreams, or more popularly, BYD. BYD sold over 1.5 million EVs in 2022, while Tesla came in second with just over 1.3 million sold. Hello everyone and welcome back to Miar Media. Today we're going to talk about who is set to dominate the EV industry in the years to come, and whether or not Tesla will be able to retain its dominant position in the global market. Before we proceed, if you haven't already subscribed to our channel, could I please request that you do so? We're a team that's working really hard to bring you these videos, and we need to reach 1,000 subscribers so YouTube will allow us to monetize our channel. Your support means everything to us, even if it's free. Now without further ado, let's dive in. Tesla is to EVs almost like Google is to search. No other electric car manufacturer can claim to dominate the EV market the way that Tesla does. The company was founded in 2003 by a group of visionaries, including, of course, the infamous Elon Musk, and set out on a mission to accelerate the world's transition to sustainable transportation. The Tesla Roadster, which became available to consumers in 2008, challenged all conventional norms and ideas of what it really meant to own a car, and shattered any preconceived notions that people had about the performance of EVs. At the time, electric cars were widely thought of as impractical and lacking performance, but the Roadster was anything but. It was a two-seater sports car that was the first highway-legal serial production all-electric car to use lithium-ion batteries. It had a range of up to 200 miles on a single charge and could accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour in an incredible 3.9 seconds. The Roadster was undeniably a runaway commercial success. It was praised for its performance, handling, and range, and helped establish Tesla as a leading manufacturer of EVs. It was also the first production car to be launched into deep space using a Falcon Heavy rocket in a test flight on February 6, 2018. Since the launch of the Roadster, Tesla has sold millions of EVs and has been continuing to innovate. In 2017, Tesla released its Model 3. This car holds a special place in the company's history as it was Tesla's first mass-market car and at $35,000 was priced significantly lower than previous Tesla models. It had a range of up to 358 miles on a single charge, which was one of the longest ranges of any electric car on the market at the time. It could also accelerate from 0 to 60 in 3.1 seconds, which put it ahead of many gasoline-powered cars. The Model 3 was packed with technology, including a large touchscreen infotainment system, autopilot driver assistance features, and over-the-air software updates, making it one of the most technologically advanced cars on the market. This was the car that made Tesla a household name and also helped to accelerate the adoption of EVs. It is still one of the most popular electric cars on the market, and since 2017, when it was first launched, Tesla's annual revenue has shot up from $11.7 billion to a staggering $81.5 billion. Tesla has clearly been the EV market leader for years, but will it be able to maintain this position in the years to come? In recent years, many new companies have entered the EV space, especially from China, and some of these new entities, like BYD and NIO, are actually becoming quite popular even beyond Chinese borders. In 2022, Chinese EV companies sold 4.4 million cars in Europe, making up almost half of all new car registrations in the bloc. And in the first quarter of 2023, Chinese company BYD led the global EV market in sales with a market share of 21%, while Tesla trailed behind with 16%. China's incredible rise in the EV space has a lot to do with strong government support. Over the last 20 years, Beijing has relentlessly promoted green energy and EVs. EV buyers, for example, get a 10% tax break when they buy a car, while EV manufacturers get generous subsidies. Some local governments in China, such as the one in Henan, have even gone so far as to set targets to completely ban combustion engine vehicles by 2030. These policies mean that Chinese EV manufacturers are able to produce, and as a result, price much more cheaply than their foreign counterparts. They also mean that EVs in China are actually cheaper than fossil fuel-powered cars. In 2022, for instance, an average gasoline car in China cost over 23,000 yuan, while an EV cost about 22. This is in stark contrast to Europe and the US, where EVs cost more than gasoline cars and also tend to keep getting more expensive. When it comes to EV manufacturing, China also has another big advantage, namely its status as the world's manufacturing hub. This means that parts and new technologies are readily available and more cost-effective for local manufacturers. Let's take batteries as an example. In 2022, China was responsible for the production of 60% of all batteries sold around the world. In fact, 13.2% of the world's supply of batteries last year actually came from BYD. The company is well known for its lithium iron phosphate or LFP batteries, which are some of the safest and most reliable on the market. It recently also released a new and improved version called the Blade battery, which is more energy dense and durable than the ones before it, and is in fact so good that even Tesla, which usually manufactures its batteries itself, began to use BYD's Blade battery in its Model Y, produced at its Gigafactory in Berlin last year. Speaking of batteries, once you've watched this video all the way through to the end, I think you might be interested in the breakthroughs in battery technology that have the potential to accelerate our transition to green energy. We recently made a video covering that topic as well, and I'll put a link to that in the description box below. So far, in our attempt to chalk out how the future of the EV industry will unfold, and whether or not Tesla will continue to dominate the EV market in the years to come, we've talked about the birth and rise of Tesla, and the incredible growth of Chinese EV manufacturers. One more topic, however, merits discussion before we can draw any conclusions around the future of the EV market and who will dominate it in the years to come. This topic is a discussion of the EV market in China itself. What makes it so important is the fact that China is currently the single biggest global market for EVs, and in 2021, it became the country with the most EVs registered that year at 3.3 million. And this number accounted for a staggering 53% of all global electric vehicle sales. China is also Tesla's second biggest market after the US, and in 2021, accounted for about 22% of the company's global sales. Recently, however, Tesla's performance in China has started to slow for a number of reasons. Firstly, while China's policies have played a crucial role in boosting its domestic EV market, they've actually done quite the opposite for Tesla. For example, China levied heavy taxes on imported cars, making it financially impractical for Tesla to bring vehicles in from the US. Tesla was eventually able to get around this, but only by establishing a manufacturing facility on Chinese soil in 2017. Then in 2021, the Chinese military accused Tesla of spying and banned the parking of Tesla cars in military bases and housing societies, making things even more difficult for the company. Secondly, as touched upon earlier, the rise of major Chinese competitors is also driving down Tesla's sales in the country. BYD in particular has taken a lot of market share away from Tesla as a result of its competitive prices, and in 2022, the company sold around 900,000 EVs in China, well ahead of Tesla's 711,000. While some believe that BYD is only strong in China and doesn't pose a threat to Tesla in the international market, that isn't really true. While the company has faced challenges internationally, it nevertheless has experienced robust sales growth and sold over 50,000 EVs outside of China in 2022, up from just 13,000 in 2021. Lastly, while the automotive industry as a whole has been experiencing supply chain constraints, including a shortage of chips and rising prices of battery raw materials, Tesla has been especially adversely affected. This is primarily because Tesla relies on a wider range of suppliers from different countries, while Chinese manufacturers have more control over their supply chains, and according to Elon Musk, supply chain issues are currently the biggest constraint on Tesla's growth. Nevertheless, despite these challenges and the recent slowdown in sales, Tesla is still well-positioned in the Chinese market. The company has a strong brand reputation and is the only foreign automaker that has a fully owned production facility in China. It's also continuing to invest heavily in the country and has plans to open a new R&D center on Chinese soil. This brings us back to our original question. Who is poised to dominate the EV industry in future, and will Tesla be able to retain its dominant position in the market? Tesla does have a number of advantages that could help it to remain a market leader, including a strong brand reputation, a loyal customer base, and a wide range of EVs. But it's also facing severe supply chain constraints and intense competition from Chinese EV makers, most prominently from BYD. Overall, it's honestly too early to call out a single company as being the market leader of the future. It's also entirely possible that there will be none, as given the intense competition in the industry, it's likely that the market will become more fragmented with multiple big players as opposed to just one.